You know, it's uncomfortable. It may be an embarrassment to talk about, but doctors understand, and they say there are ways to manage problems when it comes to using the bathroom. Today, we are talking about irritable bowel syndrome on Our House Call, and here to tell us more, Dr. Darren Wall is a board-certified gastroenterologist and member of the Cone Health Medical Group. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
I think a lot, first of all, let's talk about the symptoms. What do you classify as symptoms for irritable bowel syndrome?
Well, irritable bowel syndrome, we have something called the Rome 3 classification, and this is so physicians and patients can identify our patients who have irritable bowel syndrome. So typically it's people who have a change in bowel habits or change in frequency 3 times a month for the previous 3 months. And this is typically what is the Rome criteria, also associated with feeling better after they do move their bowel. So that's a criteria. You know, a little different than when somebody just has what we call chronic idiopathic constipation, also known as functional constipation. And there's a lot of overlap, so a lot of people who do have bowel habit problems may fall into either one of these or actually overlap them. And functional constipation is more associated with hard stools, infrequent stools, feeling of incomplete evacuation, feeling like you're obstructed, and having to strain. So as you can see, constipation can fall into both of those kind of categories.
It's one of those things that most people are very uncomfortable talking about with
Correct.
Their doctor, but still it's something you need to bring up, whether with a specialist or whether you're a general practitioner.
Correct. We're quickly approaching March, Colon Cancer Awareness Month, and yes, that's absolutely true. Colon cancer is one of the leading causes of cancer death, and you know, it's an embarrassment, and people need to know whether they're having symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome or not. The fact that, you know, knowing, and your physician will know, and you hopefully you'll learn something here today, mm-hmm. To look for the warning signs, to look for the things that may be causing us some concern and making you think twice. So if you have a family history of colon cancer or family history of colon polyps, if you have symptoms that wake you up at night, if you have blood in your stools, if you are having frequent change, a new change, not something that you've had for years, but something that really just changed. Also, weight loss is a big red flag. Mm-hmm. So if you're losing weight and you're having, change in bowel habits, it's probably not just something, nervous stomach or irritable bowel syndrome.
About how many people are affected by this?
So that's a great question. So the statistics show that we actually have this is a large portion of a typical community GI practice. It's about 2 out of 10 people at
Really?
Some time in their life, have symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome. And the vast majority of them, I talk about the iceberg, where we only see the tip of the iceberg and most
Sure.
of it is underwater. So there's a vast majority of people who are not seeking medical help who actually have signs and symptoms and fall into the categories of chronic idiopathic constipation or irritable bowel syndrome.
And as you said, the danger is not only that you're living with something that's causing you distress, it's also that it could be something much worse. And that,
Correct.
That's what plays into, getting checked out. At least ask the question, have the conversation.
Correct. The other thing is also that we have good therapies. There's not a cure for irritable bowel syndrome, but there's ways to manage it. We have medications, mm-hmm. we have things that target the brain, we have things that target the gut. So this is really a gut brain access, where stress, it's more common in women, irritable bowel syndrome. It comes in different varieties. You have people with diarrhea predominance. You have people with constipation predominance. I'm sorry, we're talking about this mm-hmm. early in the morning, right
sure.
around breakfast, that we're talking
mm-hmm.
about your bowels. But yes, and then there's alternating. Some people, which are some of our hard patients, who have diarrhea now and they'll have constipation later, and which ones you target. So those are our difficult patients.
It's an uncomfortable conversation to have, but again, it's something that you need to be discussing with your physician, and we appreciate you talking about it today.
Thank you very much.
You've got a unique opportunity coming up, and a lot of people, again, colorectal cancer is not something you really have in a big discussion, but Cone Health has something that's pretty neat. It's an interactive exhibit called the Strolling Colon. It lets you walk inside an inflatable colon and get a better understanding of how it works, but also how to prevent cancer. 2 opportunities coming up Saturday, March 10th, from 11 to 2 at the Lowe's Foods parking lot on University Drive in Burlington. Or you can check it out the next Saturday, same time. It'll be at the Whole Foods parking lot at Friendly Center in Greensboro.